Right, so here we are at RH Fisheries Sitch, and it's an absolutely stunning lake. I've never been here before, but the lads tell me that the fish do like to get around the lake a little bit. So we're gonna use the Barrow, get around the lake. If we see fish moving on the other side of the lake, we'll get on our toes, bomb it around the other side of the lake, and hopefully we'll nick one or two and hold it up for the camera for you. So I'm gonna get my gear out the back of the van, and see you soon. Okay, so we chose to set up in this area of the lake. We saw a few fish here and there, but this area is where the large amount of the fish were. We'll keep watching the water. We've only got two rod sets set up and the net, so we'll keep watching the water and hopefully something will give itself away, if not here, up the other end of the lake, in which case, if it's still on the Barrow, we'll run around with the Barrow, set up down the other end, and hopefully we'll nick one. So I'm just gonna sit here, make a cup of tea in a minute, and watch the water for a couple of hours. Hopefully something will give itself away. Morning. Well, did the night down the other end of the lake, managed to nick a little one in the night, but the fish do seem to have moved down this end of the lake. I was sitting there with my cup of tea this morning and they were showing and rolling down this end of the lake, so I put everything on the Barrow. Rather than load it in the van, I stuck it on the Barrow so I could quickly whiz round here, get two rods on the spots where I saw them jumping out, and hopefully we'll manage to catch one of these lovely sitch carp. Okay, the Barrow I'm using on this trip is the new Tune Barrow. Now it's called Tune Barrow because it fits in with all our already existing Tune luggage range. As you can see, in the bottom pouch there, in the bottom bag there, I've got the Tune Barrow organiser. And inside the Barrow organiser, I've got all my little pouches with all my tackle in it. Lots of different size, shapes, it depends what you do, you can use them however you want, there's no set rules with this. In the front, you've got two more bags either side of the wheel. You can put like heavier items like your water bottle or your bait bag, so the weight's all over the wheel. It's got highly adjustable handles to adjust depending on how tall you are. I'm quite short, so I'm told, but if you're a bit taller, lift them up like that so you're not bending your back and hurting your back when you're pushing the Barrow along. The wheel comes off so you can make that nice and easy to store in the car, and it's got this nice hard work top which is, you know, fully waterproof. Great to work from if you're tying rigs on short day sessions like this one, but it's also fully waterproof. We had a bit of rain, all the gear inside is still perfectly dry, so it's good for day sessions. Take a time out now to talk about the Barrow organiser itself and what I put inside it for this trip. Got to remember, I'm here for 3 days, so how I've set it up today, you might not necessarily set it up for a different trip like an overnighter. So within this bag I've got such things as my pop-up organiser. It's a bit sunny, so I thought I'd bring the zig box along just in case. I haven't used it this trip, but you never know, might get it out later. Obviously got my rig wallet with me, which has got a few pre-tied rigs in there. And then I've got lots of small tackle pouches, so they all fit in with each other. As you can see, like two of these make one of those. So that's how it all fits in nice and tightly. There's no wasted space. So within these little pouches, I've got things like, you know, hook links and hooks. And also I've got one down here with my leads in. And I've got the bigger one here, which has got lots of general things in. I've got my scales in there, I've got spods in there, and I've got all sorts of things in that one. But that's just my like general box to put all sorts of odds and sods in. So like I say, you don't have to set it up this way. And if I was doing an overnighter, for example, I would probably bring all this with me because I wouldn't need it all. I'd bring something more like a session cool bag with me, which fits in here lovely, alongside a few small bits and pieces that I'd have in there with it. Morning, it's the final morning of my 48 hours. The fish were all over me last night, but unfortunately I didn't manage to get one. It went quiet about 10 o'clock. First thing this morning, woke up, looked across the lake, and there was showing at the far side of the lake. It's a little bit far for me to cast from here, so I'm gonna, as you can see, I've got everything on my barra. I'm gonna reel the rods in, I'm gonna run around there and try and get one in the last couple of hours. Okay, last chance saloon, I've got 2 hours left. I've come around to the other side of the lake, this is my third swim now. Chucked it all back on the barrow, rolled it round here. I'm just taking the bare minimums, which is like a tackle pouch, my net, my two rods and my buzzers. And I've chucked out 2 bags, you know, with a few boilies in, just hoping to nick that one bite, which would make this trip even better than it already has been. Well, that's it, no fish this morning I'm afraid, just a little one on the first night. We've been in 3 different swims, we've given it a really good go, we've been using the barrow, getting around the lake really quickly rather than unloading and loading the van, which would have taken up valuable fishing time. If you haven't got yourself a barrow, I suggest you go and get yourself one because they're a really good tool to use on short day sessions. And that's it really, I'm not going to go home now. The only problem is I've got to remember where I parked the van. See you later.